Peter's father was of Lebanese extraction, but had migrated to Brazil, where he engaged in, the Argentine, but he was, his work was on the Argentine-Brazilian border. And I'm not actually sure, actually, between Brazil and Argentine where he established. But he married an English woman there, so Peter's mother was English, and they lived in Buenos Aires, I think. But his father was made his money by collecting stones, some precious stones, some semi-precious stones like agate, on the Brazilian-Argentine border. And there was a big export trade of that. And he became, I think, not very wealthy, but quite wealthy enough to send his son, no doubt at his wife's insistence, or between them, the husband and wife, sent their son to Marlborough School, which was a big influence on Peter. He had, he was taught by a master whose name I've forgotten, but came up in his tutorials. He talked about his master a bit, the schoolmaster who'd influenced him. And that was a an old-fashioned public school, as distinct from a Quaker school. And he then went on to take a degree in zoology.
At Oxford.
At Oxford. He did not take a PhD, or DPhil it would have been in Oxford, and he didn't particularly encourage me, actually. You don't need to take a DPhil if you don't want to. He was out of date about that. You didn't need to by the time I was taking it, but he hadn't done so. He had started, as I say, as an embryologist. There were the smartest thing that Peter Medawar ever did was not to start working with Gibson on the homograph reaction, but to marry Jean, his wife. At the time I first knew her, a stunningly good-looking young woman, already with a flock of little children. I suppose sort of fell in love with her completely at the time, and I've always think I have the greatest admiration for her. She managed Peter's life successfully, and she turned him into a helped turn him into a respectable English professor, British professor. And by the time I'd finished in Oxford, he'd already been away for a year, taking his first chair as professor of zoology in Birmingham. And he went on, he came back to University College, he completed, he was going on working on the homograph reaction, and he, with his colleagues, Billingham and Brent, discovered immunological tolerance, for which he was awarded the Nobel Prize.
Right.
So that was terrific research. And then he went on to become director of the National Institute for Medical Research.